be deliberated upon, agreed to by the board, all right? And I know that how it works. Technical committee, you make your recommendation to the board, right. The board will sit and pick their man. But that's not the only thing.
Okay.
They are also trying to tell us the reasons why Le Guin rejected the contract. He doesn't want to be given a target, according to the press release,
okay.
which I'm sure you have also seen. Mm-hmm. He doesn't want to be given a target. He doesn't want to leave
in Nigeria.
In Nigeria.
Okay.
I was told that he said, look, you guys are ranked 70th in the world, so why are you giving me a target to qualify for the World Cup? That shouldn't be part of it. So that's the reason that they gave.
Let's balance it. Also
let's balance
from
it.
The NFF. Mm. That's what came out of today.
Yesterday, Toyin, we got a release from the Nigeria Football Federation. I'm a graduate of mass communication, the inverted pyramid style of writing.
Yes.
I'll tell you the headline that says, Paul Le Guin is new Super Eagles technical advisor. The first paragraph reads, the Technical and Development Committee of the Nigeria Football Federation on Monday named Frenchman Paul Le Guin, 52 years old, as the new technical advisor of the senior national team Super Eagles. You know what?
Go on.
Let me come back and speak as a football follower in Nigeria. I've read
their
first paragraph.
Don't stop there.
Okay.
It's not the first paragraph.
Okay.
Finish
he
the paragraph.
Will be assisted by Nigeria Salisu Yusuf, who takes the role of chief coach. The appointment, are subject to agreements of contract terms with the NFF Executive Committee. Fine.
That's what they are holding on to.
What is the normal football follower in Nigeria holding on to? That we already have someone ready to work. Straight up, because that's coming from the NFF.
Let us make his point.
It's coming from the NFF. Now, if the NFF wasn't certain, and the executive committee wasn't even in the know of what the technical committee they were doing, you don't have to come whet the appetite of Nigerians.
Exactly. They tweeted about this. That's what I wanted to say.
It's totally unacceptable.
They tweeted about this.
Wait, hold on. So is your anger about the tweeting or the entire process that we've just spoken about? The tweet is
the anger is that somebody has been playing with our mindset.
That's the thing.
People
if
have not been working.
You have not come to terms with this person. Why go to the social media and tweet? It's coming from the journalism point of view. I'm coming from
the average fan.
I'm coming from the, because I deal with it. I'm a blogger. I'm coming from there. Now,
you bloggers don't do investigation. You just make stories.
I am a trained journalist. I am a trained journalist. And there's something. He just mentioned that the inverted pyramid style of writing a story. Now, they tweeted about it. I screen grabbed the tweet. I read it out this morning. They tweeted about it. Nigeria has appointed Paul Le Guin as coach. So, if you know you have not come to terms with him, so why would you do that? I mean,
so you follow the report. Follow the report from Lokyup. You will know
that
this man, not much was even said to him. He doesn't even know much about football. He didn't even have enough briefing. He didn't even love the country to even come to even work with us. You know, the passion, he couldn't even feel it. Was he even interviewed at all? That's what I want. The NFF
Hold on. Let's balance things a little bit. The NFF have made us to understand that they didn't want to go through what happened the last time when they just brought someone, and at the end of the day, the person said, "You guys begged me 3-4 times. I didn't want the job." So they did. They had people submit application. They
and
had
a
shortlisting.
Okay.
And then they said they were going to be interview, and then they will make their choice. Is that what you guys are complaining about? Or the fact that somebody was so much in a rush, and this story was out, and they now have to backtrack?
Now I'm beginning to feel nobody was interviewed.
Yes.
There was no shortlist.
Yes.
No, there was a shortlist.
Shortlist to three. When were these three persons interviewed? No,
that's
they
the
have
thing.
No.
That's the
NSF
thing.
Needs
that's
to,
the thing.
We need to know when they were interviewed because this thing went on, and we're waiting for appetite. We were pleased. Do you know the amount of research I've done on Paul Le Guin?
Okay.
I can pass an exam on that man's life.
We'll come back and talk about all of this. I'll read comments on Twitter as well about all of these issues, but we need to go on a quick break. We'll be back with more on Sports Tonight. Join us again.
ChannelsTV.com is your most trusted news website using responsive design for a richer user experience. Get the latest information as it happens politics, sports, business, entertainment, health, and more. Access our content on all our social media platforms. To access the world, you only need ChannelsTV.com. The news at your fingertips.
Getting more than just the news is to ask straight and incisive questions. And these are excuses from the government?
No. Is that right?
And not settle for just any answer.
It's lost 2 years harvest as a result of Boko Haram insurgents.
We're talking of the real issues right now. Tomatoes is just one example. We speak to those behind the news and get details on issues the way they affect you. Dateline Abuja offers you a deeper perspective of what's in the news.
If the story means much to you, then join those who tell it on Eyewitness Report.
All they need to do is send their people out there and come and have a look and see how bad the roads are.
Dredging activities should stop. But we notice that it's still going on and escalating.
Get those videos and photos uploaded on your Eyewitness portal on the Channels TV app with your name and address. The Channels TV Eyewitness Report. Your story is just but a click away.
All right, thank you for staying with us. I said I was going to read a few comments on Twitter. Doyin Kasumu says, the way forward for us, the way forward for us is inwards. The forex that we should have wasted on a foreigner should be used to develop our coaches. That's coming from Doyin Kasumu. Israel Akinlawon says that the white man is not ready to reside here. NFF should swallow its pride and engage Salisu Yusuf before it is too late. That's what it says. Kingsley Ojernide says, you are the... I didn't get this one. It looks like it's very mixed up. Why did they announce the deal then? That's coming from Kingsley Ojernide. How can you... okay, he's talking about announcing the deal when it hadn't been concluded.
That's what I'm saying, that they tweeted about it, and of course, they brought out a release about it.
Yeah, also, you were on a point before we went on that break.
That's right. I said, who interviewed those guys shortly? Because we've heard that Saint Faith was waiting. He was waiting on Skype.
There was supposed to be a Skype interview for the three guys.
I'm not sure
they were
lying to us. At this stage of our football, nobody should lie to us because Nigerian football
is hurting. Cosmos, what was the lie? What lie are you insinuating?
Wait, we were told that they were going to be interviewed via Skype on Monday.
And, no interview.
And as far as what we know and what we heard, there was no interview.
Okay.
Now, that is the thing. Now,
nullify the process, the entire process, because we couldn't do the Skype interview? Should that have given credence to the entire process?
As far as I'm concerned, because we've been hearing about Paul Le Guen for weeks. Paul Le Guen is the new coach and all that. And of course, the denial from the sport ministry, from the NFF and all that. We'll be hearing on that. So they said there was supposed to be an interview for three people. Le Guen, Saint Fit, and Salisu. But then, as far as we know, it did not hold. Even Saint Fit said he was waiting on Skype. So, you know...
Okay, we have to go now. Way forward.
The person that tweeted just said it. Look inwards. Get a coach. There's a qualifiers, and it's a very important one. Just get a coach and let
way forward. Way forward.
Way forward. I'll tell you tomorrow.
Tomorrow,
this NFF is not ready yet.
No
way forward.
All right, we'll continue this discourse tomorrow. And I must say thank you to you for watching. We'll be back tomorrow with a bigger and a better one. Thank you. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye bye now.